Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. A regional consultation bringing together stakeholders from across the region for what was dubbed a study of human trafficking in the Cariforum region took place at the Accra Beach Resort, Barbados, from the 19th to the 20th of September 2019. St. Lucia was represented by the Assistant Focal Point for Trafficking in Persons within the Department of Home Affairs and National Security, Claudia Monlouis, and a member of the Task Force for the Prevention of the Trafficking in Persons, Yolanda Jules Louis. The consultation aimed to conduct a comprehensive assessment of human trafficking in the Cariforum region to provide advice on key findings and recommendations to inform priority response interventions to determine the extent and nature of human trafficking in Cariforum, to provide recommendations on the implementation of programs to halt or significantly reduce trafficking in persons. St. Lucians got to experience the unveiling of the 40th Independence All-In Monument at a brief ceremony which took place at the Castries waterfront last Friday. The sculpture, which was designed by world-renowned sculptor Jallim Eudovic, was originally called Le Péché and formed part of Eudovic's Kudme exhibition in 2010. Eudovic explained that the definition of Kudme being the collective strength of the indigenous communities aligns with the theme for this year's independence, All In. Prime Minister of St. Lucia expressed contentment in the level of work executed by the young, talented St. Lucian sculptor. The All In monument stands at 12 feet 6 inches tall, overlooking the harbour on the Castries waterfront. The Ministry of Health and Wellness has completed its review of the impact of the U.S. Naval Ship Comfort medical mission in St. Lucia. The United States Naval Ship Comfort led its humanitarian mission to St. Lucia from September 23rd to October 2nd, 2019, where over 5,000 patients were attended to free of charge. General services included basic evaluation and treatment, preventative medicine, dental screening and treatment, eye care, pediatrics, dermatology, and surgical care. Apart from the services offered to patients, the crew imparted knowledge and skills to local practitioners. Deputy Permanent Secretary in the Department of External Affairs, Irene Gaspard, is grateful for the collaboration which made the mission possible, including the conduct of those seeking medical care. The visit of the USNS Comfort was part of the ship's five-month deployment to Latin America and the Caribbean on a medical assistance mission. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.